Number 10, the Large Hadron Collider. Understanding and unlocking the universe's weirdest mysteries necessitates a thorough understanding of physics and the requisite instruments. The creation of the Large Hadron Collider, which allows scientists to establish the presence of an elusive particle known as the Higgs boson, was motivated by this goal. The tunnel is lined with electromagnets to regulate this operation, making it the world's largest and most productive machine. Since its inception in 2010, the LHC's seven detectors have accomplished what they set out to do. More plans are in the works to substitute it with an even larger collider that can answer the issues presented by what the LHC has discovered. Number 9, the International Space Station. The International Space Station launched in 1998. It isn't the biggest machine or vehicle ever constructed, but it is unquestionably one of the most spectacular objects ever designed by humanity and has set numerous records. It is the ninth of the 11 space stations that have reached Earth's orbit, but it is by far the largest. It was created and is operated as an international partnership amongst the majority of the world's spacefaring nations. It is a vital tool for scientific investigation into microgravity's impacts and the large universe. It orbits the globe once every 90 minutes and 2.68 seconds. If this speed could be achieved at ground level, it would only take 35 minutes to get from New York to Australia. Number 8, Bertha Tunnel Borer. The Alaskan Way Viaduct is a vital transportation route through Seattle. Rather than building a new road above ground, plans were made to construct a substitute. The decision was to build a massive tunnel beneath downtown Seattle to connect the city's southern and northern parts. The engineers had to overcome the difficulty of tunnel construction because there was no machine on Earth large enough for what they wanted. Hence, Bertha was designed as part of the project. Bertha was the largest tunnel borer ever built at the cost of $80 million. The 6,700-ton machine had a cutter head diameter of 57.5 feet and was 326 feet long. Number 7. The 500-meter Aperture Spherical Radio Telescope. The 500-meter Aperture Spherical Radio Telescope, often known as FAST, is the world's most giant-filled aperture radio telescope. It was constructed in an optimum-sized flat area within the countryside in southwest China. FAST took 5 years to build. It took another 4 years to attain full industrial capacity once it opened for testing in 2016. Since its operation, it can detect wavelengths between 4 inches and 14 inches and has discovered 44 previously unknown pulsars. It has become a visitor attraction in its own right, not only because it has substantially boosted researchers' ability to study the far reaches of the universe. Number 6. Antonov An-225 Mirya. When traveling through an airport terminal, you'll frequently see much larger airplanes than you might imagine, ranging from the Airbus A380 to large cargo transports. It appears that they will never be able to lift themselves into the air. But not even that can withstand the most powerful plane ever made. The only Antonov An-225 Mirya was manufactured in 1985. The Soviets needed a way to transport the Buran space plane, which was their space shuttle version. The Mirya needed a lot of stability and power to get the spacecraft to the launch center. So the 276-foot-long, 60-foot-tall aircraft with a 290-foot wingspan was outfitted with 6 Progress D18 turbofans that could each generate 229 kilonewton of torque. It's still in use today for operations like sending supplies to relief organizations worldwide and transporting the heaviest pieces of air freight like wind turbine blades and power plant light generators. Number 5. Prelude FLNG. Large drilling platforms cover oceanic oil fields all over the world to harvest as much of the valuable commodity as possible. On the other hand, Shell completed the Prelude FLNG, the world's largest offshore facility, in 2013. At over 1,600 feet long, 243 feet wide, and holding more than 260,000 tons of steel, it has five times the water displacement of a Nimitz-class aircraft carrier. It's held in place by 16 213-foot-long seabed-driven steel piles, which means it can resist the most challenging weather, including a level 5 typhoon. The sheer enormity of this platform is almost incomprehensible, but with a predicted lifespan of 25 years, it will ensure that lucrative fields continue to produce for many years. Number 4. Seawise Giant. The Seawise Giant set sail for the first time in 1979 and is still the world's largest ship. It was intended to be used as a supertanker, but at 1,542 feet long, it was too large to pass via the English Channel, the Suez Canal, or the Panama Canal. The hull's bottom would submerge up to 81 feet beneath the water's surface when fully loaded, with a displacement of over 650,000 tons. Building such a massive vessel wasn't without its challenges. The sea-savvy giant first experienced tremors that were so alarming that the corporation that commissioned it refused delivery. It performed better than expected following a refit, with 46 crude oil tanks, a massive 230-ton rudder, and a 50-ton propeller. Number 3. Tradino, the robot dragon. The German town of Fürth, located in Bavaria, is also known as the Dragon City, and they take this title seriously. Every year, a street drama called Dragon Stuff is produced, based on a tradition that dates back to the 16th century and relates the story of Saint George fighting a dragon. The core spectacle of the show, as you might assume, is the dragon itself. In 2001, organizers determined that their props were becoming too old and worn, so they devised plans for an enormous dragon robot that would become the nation's most giant freely walking robot. It took about 10 years to design and construct, and it was featured prominently during the 2010 production of Tradino. It has over 1,000 feet of hydraulic lines and 4,000 feet of electrical wires for extra effect. It can also transport 17.5 gallons of artificial blood and 2.5 gallons of liquefied gas, allowing the gigantic behemoth to ooze and blow the fire up to 5 feet from its mouth. Number 2. La Princesse. In 2008, the unveiling of La Princesse, one of the world's largest mechanized vehicles, was held in Liverpool, England. It was created by a machine, a French performance art organization that sought to create a massive robot spider that could stroll around the streets. It took more than a year to build, with steel wood and intricate hydraulics, but the result was spectacular. It is undoubtedly one of the most complex entertainment devices ever created, and beating it would need tremendous dedication and enthusiasm. Number 1. The Panzer VIII Maus. The German military invested heavily in developing formidable weapons, focusing on building the most extensive war machines yet devised. As a result, the Panzer VIII Maus was born, still the world's largest fully enclosed armored vehicle, which was 33 feet and 6 inches long, 12 feet and 2 inches broad, and just under 12 feet tall, required a 6-man crew, which included a commander, a gunner, 2 loaders, a driver, and a radio operator. The Maus was a revolutionary tank that could punch holes in enemy defenses while sustaining minor damage. It would have changed the course of the war if it had ever been effectively deployed. There we have it! If you want to see more of these enormous machines that take to the skies, seas, and more to undertake various tasks, Make sure to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. And I will see you next time. Bye!